How you doing? I'm doing a video on how I spoil the heck out of my birds, songbirds, trying to feed the cardinals and the blue jays and our red-bellied woodpecker that we call Woody. He's the guy that knocks on the house when I've run out of suet or peanut butter. I got him so spoiled. So first of all, this is a suet feeder that I designed and built, and you can see I have a commercial grade suet block, rendered suet, in there. And then I put a corn on the cob over here, you know, dry corn, and a big dollop of peanut butter. So I made this thing out of hardware cloth, as you can see. Now this side is full of just supermarket suet, non-rendered, and I use that only in the cold months, never in the summertime, because it'll go rancid. You can see I've got these 2 8-ounce weights under here, and that's so it doesn't swing like heck when we get, you know, 30-40 mile an hour gusts. This just keeps it real tight to the pole so the birds don't get all crazy. But I spoil the hell out of them. You know, I threw a couple of raisins on top here, as you could see. And it looks like somebody's been working on this thing. I don't know who's been capable of climbing up here, but it looks like some of the metal's actually broken, which I've never had this trouble before. I'm just going to grab a pair of pliers and fix this. Now that I've got this, you know, non-rendered suet, it looks like somebody's been climbing up and doing some damage. But so that's one of my rigs, you know. And then the next rig I want to show you, I have here, and I hope I don't dump it all over. Like I said, I spoil them. I made this thing years ago, drilled a couple of holes in the wood, and I got a nice big dry corn on the cob over there. And I use Skippy Extra Chunky. It's my favorite peanut butter that I use when I eat peanut butter sandwiches. So I figured if it's good enough for me, I may as well spoil the hell out of my birds. And I don't like the ones that are high sugar, the peanut butters that are really, really sweet. What's the name of that one, Donna?
Peter Pan.
Peter Pan. I don't like Peter Pan. It's too sugary. I don't think the high sugar is good for us, and I don't think it's good for my birds. But you see, I got this box here, and I've got, you know, some really nice seeds. I mean, I feed them good. I got whole peanuts, and I got raisins and all kinds of goodies. And you know, I've got all things that they could sit on, and you know, I spoil the heck out of them. And so that's a couple more pounds. Don't want that falling over. And you can see how they pick the cobs clean. And I want to go get something. You can just wait right here. Now this is my main bird feeder. There's three tubes, and this is 12 pounds of seeds. We go through this about once every week and a half, maybe. And I've got all black oil seeds in one, all black oil seeds in number two, and then a mixture of bird seed in number three. But that's 12 pounds. So, and I got this squirrel guard that normally goes on a pole. You could see how I custom did the top there with JB Weld. And, normally used as squirrel guard so squirrels can't climb up the bird feeder. It does not work at all. So I converted it and made it into a big dome cover for the bird feeder. and it just keeps the seed drier, and I get less mash rot seed on the bottom by having that big dome. And I'm going to hold this all the way up, and I don't know if you can see it under there or not, but it's perforated. I drilled hundreds of little holes underneath there to allow for moisture transmission, so that there's, if any water does get in, it'll drain out and it will not accumulate like a puddle, and I won't get rot, seed rot on the bottom, and then the bottom will rust out. So I wire brushed the bottom of this and treated it with Rudy Brown rust inhibitor paint, which is made with cod liver oil, which is natural, and then I used an enamel, a brown oil-based enamel, so it's really, really protected, so the bottom doesn't rot out. Because these things are $75, these bird feeders. So all total between this big, you can back up just a little careful. You see, between this 12 pounds and all that, every 2 weeks I put out around 16 pounds of bird food. Like I said, I spoil my birds. One last thing, I wanted to show you how I use linseed oil on all my shovels and hay forks and soil forks. You can see how they've got a nice good coat of linseed oil on them. And it protects the handles from rotting. And I bring them in every winter and I treat them. You can see this shovel here. I found this behind the rock wall. It's got to be from the 50s or 40s or something. Still my favorite shovel, even though there's a lot of splits in the handle and some porcupine chew marks where they're trying to get salt out of the wood from, sweat. But, I can still flip pretty big boulders in the soil with this, even though it's got an old weak handle. But I love it because it's featherweight and it's very sharp. I can shovel like a machine with this old one compared to all the new ones they make. So that's about it. I hope you enjoyed my little explanation on how I spoil my birds and how I care for my gardening tools. Take care.